At dumako naman tayo sa isang napapanahong paksang tungkol sa Christian time management sa mga kwento ng pag-asa ni Eden Relente.
Kamusta mga kakwentuhan? Maligayang panonood muli dito sa Kwento ng Pag-asa. Mga kakwentuhan, we all know that a day holds a lot of time. 24 hours, 1,440 minutes, 86,400 seconds. Yet, for most of us, our daily cry is, "If only I had more time." Can you relate mga kakwentuhan? We all feel so busy, overwhelmed by our lengthy and never-ending to-do list as a student, as a worker, as a parents, and many more. Kung kayo po ay kagaya ko na mahilig magsulat ng everyday plan, weekly plan, or yearly plan, minsan prone tayo sa stress, right? And as much as possible, we should avoid procrastination. At kung kayo ay kagaya ko din, lahat tayo ay ayaw ng interruptions, lalo na pag tayo ay may nakaschedule na nagagawin in a particular time. Wala naman pong masama sa ating pagta-time management, mga kakwentuhan. In fact, God loves time management. He is always punctual. He always acts at the right time, even though to us humans, it may seem like we have to wait a long time. But how to do Christian time management, not in our own way, but in a Christian way? I will share to you three principles, mga kakwentuhan. First is to prioritize. God wants us to become His children, to be like Him. Hebrews 2 verse 10 and 1 John 3, 1-3. To be more like God, we need to learn to have His priorities. We need to learn to use those priorities to produce a plan for improving our lives and aligning them to God's plan. And we need to put those plans into action. God's priorities and plans always produce results, and so can ours. Second principle, mga kakwentuhan, is plan. The Bible reveals a God who is a planner, and He wants us to be planners too. We need long-range plans, annual plans, and daily plans, and probably several plans in between. Why plan? Lolly Daskal explains that planning our time is not about filling every moment with busy work, but rather organizing our time around what is important. Planning for how to spend your time enables you to work far more efficiently than figuring it out as you go. What is planned happened because planning leads to action. Lastly, mga kakwentuhan, the third principle is practice. Apostle Paul encouraged us to walk circumspectly, not as fools but as wise, redeeming the time because the days are evil. Ephesians 5 verse 15 to 16. God wants us to recognize that every minute counts and should be used in a godly way. And He wants us to learn diligence and avoid laziness. Okay, so mga kakwentuhan, God created time as a tool. We were put in this universe of time to learn many lessons and to develop the character of God. Tandaan, out of the three principles that we had discussed, Christian time management means learning to use time as God wants us to use it. That's it mga kakwentuhan. Kung kayo po ay may gustong topics na nais pang pag-usapan or kayo ay may kwento tungkol sa pagpapala ng Diyos sa inyong buhay, you can send it to Kwento ng Pag-asa Facebook page or email us through info@hopechannel.ph or post in any of your social media account and don't forget the hashtag, #KNP. Hanggang sa muli mga kakwentuhan, this is Eden Relente ng Kwento ng Pag-asa.